Hey everybody, ChristopherOdd here. Welcome back. This is Blood and Wine. I think this is about the right time to do something that we've always wanted to do. And that is to meet a painter around noon, which is, well, I mean, we're an hour and a half late. We're gonna meet him by the western gate of the palace so that he can paint us as an old man, apparently. I'm intrigued. I'd like to see where this goes. There's a couple of other side quests that I think will be rather interesting that I'm going to embark on now before we head towards the end of the main quest. We're not going to get them all done, but some of the interesting ones at least. And this one at least seemed interesting to me. We'll see if it's a matter of, like, he's just going to do it and then he gives us a painting and that's it, or if there's more to it. Either way, it's art, you know? And you have to just appreciate art. And you have to appreciate running. And you have to appreciate running up these giant hills that we could totally just be teleporting over. And we could just be riding our horse, who could probably handle this stamina-wise way better than we can. But we also have to get in some cardio from time to time.
Bloody hell.
And he's here.
I'm here.
Let us go. We should arrive in time to have the best light of the day. The chiaroscuro we shall capture. Just glorious.
All right, let's do it. I'm intrigued.
Let's go. The things I do for art.
We had best ride there. But we'll arrive faster and less fatigued.
That's fine.
A work of mine. Turtle dove o'er the heath hangs in the ducal palace.
So does a cockatrice I cut down once. It's stuffed, maybe with heather.
I once had a cockatrice feather brush. Best thing for laying down tempera.
Oh yeah, I no longer gotta lay down that tempera.
My blasted cat swiped it.
Why would a cat want a brush?
To paint with, of course. And wow. It was no common brush. Fantastic, as I said, and fantastically expensive.
Hang on, got a cat that paints?
Yeah.
You could make some serious money with that.
He merely copies the works of his betters, and poorly at that.
Your cat?
Yes. Pierre Auguste Moustachewa. It's no surprise.
Moustachewa.
He's a second-rate hack and a thief. We'll continue on.
This is a nice backdrop. Oh, we're going higher. Okay, I like this.
Truly. I can only speak through my paintings.
Is that so?
Ladies, gentlemen, my lieges, forgive me for being forward, but have you perchance seen a set of paints and brushes nearby?
Eugenie, I believe this peasant wants something from us.
Uh-oh.
My paints, my brushes, I had prepared them. They were here.
We've not seen any journeyman's tools, my good man. Of that I assure you.
They're a problem?
Yes, an immense one. I cannot possibly paint without my paints.
Well,
I'm done for.
Either you didn't leave them here, or these guys took them.
You would be kind enough to locate them?
Wouldn't happen to have another set with you? And, nothing you could use instead?
My word. Would you really have me scrawl with charcoal like an animal?
No, you're right. That would be totally not cool.
Damn it. Sure you left them here?
Yes, right there. I'd prepared everything. Set it out. Ordered and organized.
Might have toppled downhill or something.
How are we gonna locate them?
Look around.
We're just gonna.
I think it is life that imitates art.
I mean, we can't follow
and
them by scent or anything.
Right, you are, Fingal. Take Baron de Cordel.
Oh, I got something over here.
Yes. That nose.
Spilled paint. Reeks.
Oh, I wasn't lying.
Of turpentine.
And now
oil paints.
His cousin.
Oh, something stepped in them.
Footprints. Clear, but curiously small.
Little kids? Oh, I can smell it now, too.
leather stain. Could very well be a lead.
Let's keep going. It could be one of those little godlings. That'd be cool. Oh, actually, shit, it might be.
Clear, but curiously small.
We're going into a cave.
Another stain. Could very well be a lead.
Or it could just be like... Yeah, I don't think it's gonna... Yeah, little neckers, huh? Okay, let's get the necrophage oil going here. Let's not dick around. Let's also throw on our decoctions. Oh, that skill's so good! Be cool, everyone. Be cool. Oh, God. There it is. What are these guys doing with the paints? They probably just like how it smells. Gotta repair that weapon. Oh, they're doing their own drawings.
Cave paintings. This here looks a bit like a necker. Big blobs, what? A troll?
Yep.
Neckers depicting their victory over some trolls? That even possible?
Necker is it victory or is it a worship? Here's the paints.
Paints don't look ruined. Painter should still be able to use them.
Okay, let's do a little repair here, shall we? That's armor repair, armor. Here we go. Beautiful. Done. So, they took those intentionally to make that painting. That was not an accident. I mean, they probably didn't search out paints, but when they stumbled upon it and realized what they could be used for, then... Okay, what the hell? Then why not? You're gonna be happy.
Found your things.
Splendid. Where were they? And... is this all you found?
Are you serious?
So much more.
Should have kept it all with you, not left it lying around. Followed some paint tracks to a necker lair. Seems the beasts made off with your supplies. Used it to paint a fresco on one of the cave walls. Looked something like a battle scene to me.
Impossible. They splashed paint on the wall in a rage. Important.
Right, but your cat can paint.
It's a good thing you found the basic colors. Shall we? While waiting, I spied a superior spot.
Let's do it. I'm curious to see how this turns out. This thing will be worth millions. Oh, we actually have paintings to hang at our house now because we bought some when we were doing all the Gwent stuff.
We have had fantastic luck with the weather. The light is perfect, absolutely perfect.
Painting this masterpiece gonna take long?
Only 6 hours. The sun won't allow us to work.
Painting this masterpiece gonna take long.
But the time will fly by. We'll chat, swap tales.
How about you just lead the way?
Down a potion. Time will definitely fly by in a state of lethargy. No need to swap tails.
No. Your expression, your posture, they must be just so. You must look alive with fire in your gaze. Lethargy is out of the question.
Come on, give it some thought. You could title the painting, A Witcher Lying Senselessly on the Heath.
You jest. A jesting witcher.
I am a jesting witcher. A witcher that jests. Many jests will be had by this witcher. And witcher jests are the best kinds of jests. I was going for a Dr. Seuss type of thing there, but didn't really flow. Oh, this is nice,
slow
actually.
Now. Whoa.
Look at this.
Is the place?
Yes. Just look at the view. Breathtaking. The perfect background for our masterpiece.
Pretty, I guess.
Now, you must carefully consider in what pose you wish to be immortalized.
Oh, nice.
All right. Considering.
Do I get to pick? Come on. Let me have that.
All is ready.
Okay.
We may begin. Have you decided on the pose you'd like to adopt?
I think so. Downward dog. on horseback. Yeah, you know what? I'd like to get Roach in there. He's a very integral part of this story. And I think that would be the most fitting. Reclining, yeah, that would be fun. But horseback.
How about I be on horseback? I mean, Roach kind of deserves to be immortalized too.
Oh, yes. A horse. Exceptional idea. But I would rather you perch atop Alexander.
Not happening.
I've trained him to pose.
Nope. It's Roach or nothing.
I shall paint in the carcass of a slain griffin later. Now, raise your head to exude pride. Thrust your breast forward. Go on, breast forward. I want to see those hocks extended.
No!
Is the horse paying attention?
This is not fair.
May I begin? Or would you rather try a different pose?
Different pose.
Let me try something else.
Doesn't feel right if it's not Roach. Let's see what heroic is like.
Maybe I could just stand, sword in hand.
Ah, splendid! A heroic pose, of course! The bold warrior, his sword held aloft, ready to run at that willow over there. I will paint in a griffin later. Shall I begin? Or would you prefer to adopt another pose?
Let's see. That's pretty nice. Let's see what the lounging one is like.
Let me try something else.
He's gonna get pissed.
Think I'll lie down. At least that way I can nap while you work.
The hero at rest, lying on his side, propped up on an elbow, staring into the distance, relishing a victory. I can paint in a griffin corpse later. Though, naturally, a nap is out of the question. We resolved that earlier. May I begin? Or would you prefer to strike a more dynamic pose?
You don't like this pose? I actually think this is great. Yeah, let's do it.
Go ahead.
Now, be so kind as to adopt that look you gave me when I first asked you to work with me.
What do you mean, like your crazy look?
That intense scowl of an angry wild ram about to butt heads. Yes, excellent. Now, hold that. Do not budge.
This gonna take much longer?
Not much at all. We'll run out of daylight soon. Please, keep your head still. In the same position.
That would hurt your arm after a while.
I'll also try to remember to never trust a painter again.
Griffin!
Yeah, I know. You'll paint one in later.
Oh, a real one!
Gods! A griffin! in!
Let's go! Didn't see that coming.
And hide.
Dearest mommy!
Okay. Oh, we almost went off the ledge there. Not good. Swoop! This is gonna be bad. Try and get some Igni going in here, but it's gone now. Oh, we got him. No, thank you. That was a good little combo we had there. Oh, hello. Don't fly off the ledge. Come on. Guess you won't need to Photoshop that in there, pal.
Is it safe?
Yeah, come on out. And no wonder no one ever came here. It was a griffin's hunting ground.
Oh, that thing scared me to death!
Not quite to death. You are alive. Not least because you chose a witcher to sit for you. How's the painting? It survived too?
It did. But I cannot show it to
you. Oh, you've got to be shitting me.
I never display unfinished work. You can see it tomorrow, after midday, where we met. I shall display it in the market square. Oof, monstrous beast. Shall we immortalize it in the painting?
Yeah, do it.
Yeah, let's add it. Carcass can serve as your prop.
Splendid. Hmm. Interesting color palette. And the textures, and the proportions. It will do. Yes, it will do. But I shall paint it in later, in my atelier. There's an excellent illustration in the Encyclopedia Maxima Mundi. I fear this specimen is, well, too far cut and chopped.
Sorry.
Ah, very well. That will do for now. I shall polish the details later.
No point struggling on in this fading light. Ah, I almost forgot. Payment for your troubles. And I thank you for saving my life. Though, in doing so, you did also save your likeness. For posterity.
Right, for posterity. Cool. Alright, well, we do need to rest. And we'll go till, like, the next morning. We might as well take what we can from here. Shall we? Let's ride. Whoa. Okay, well, I thought it was just gonna be a casual little painting, and I guess it did kind of start out like that. Then, take down a griffin. Gotta keep our Witcher senses on point, you know? It's okay. Slow. Wouldn't be much of Witcher if we never took down any beasts. Now, griffin's pretty formidable. Oh yeah, this is up that, yeah, it's up the back way here. We're being forbidden from running here. I can understand why, but really necessary. You know what? I'm gonna have to go through here. Ooh.
Nothing to see here.
There we go. Roach always knows where to be and when to be there.
Run, Roach.
It's a beautiful soul. Like, look at this. I love this place. This is so cool looking. I got distracted. I'm not even following the path anymore.
What's new, mon ami?
Not much.
You'll not find work here. Not paying work.
Long live her grace! Three cheers for Toussaint!
Let's see it. Oh my god. It's not even close.
Greetings.
And there's
Geralt,
a cat in the picture.
There you are. So, painting. Are you pleased? Is it to your liking? Do tell.
I mean, it's not even... It's not quite what I expected.
Not exactly what I imagined. I believe I posed with all my clothes on. Clearly remember that, in fact. Some other details are off, too.
Invalid as a criticism. I depicted you in
invalid as a criticism,
state.
He says.
The painting has drawn crowds, aroused a great deal of interest.
Yeah, from women.
Can see that. Anyway, some advice for the future. Warn your subjects about your intentions. Your next model might not be so forgiving.
You don't like it. I'm hurt. Perhaps you'd care to buy the painting.
Are you freaking joking?
Given our rapport, I shall take a loss. For you, I'll part with it. I will. At a special
price. This guy's playing me like a fiddle.
As special as it is, That's still quite a price. Afraid I don't have that much coin.
Not a problem. Come back when you do. Though I cannot guarantee someone won't have.
I'm pretty sure it's gonna last. Pretty sure it's going to last. What else do we have? What else do we have? Anything nearby? There is this island here, which I think would be kind of cool. The isle on Lac Selavi. We could try that. I like that. I wish the painting would have been, like, legit, and then I could have... I would have bought it. But we're pretty low on cashola right now. We have 1,100. Like, we can buy it, but if we are gonna, if we're gonna get closer to the Grandmaster gear, we're gonna need to sell some stuff sooner rather than later. Okay, there's this Chuchote Cave. I guess let's head there. That's pretty close to where we need to be. Good girl.
Faster.
How come we're not, how can we not let me cruise here? What the hell, Roach? You okay? You sick? That's weird. I can't race. Oh well. You need to go to the aisle, it says, so I'm gonna cross. Need any boots. Okay, so as a refresher here, this island. Upon a notice board in Toussaint, Geralt spotted a mysterious notice inviting all who dared to undergo a test of virtue. All who wished to face the challenge clearly to their character above all were to find their way to the isle upon Lac Selavi. Our Witcher found the notice intriguing enough that he resolved to see what the test entailed. We'll probably fail it. Oh, there's somebody here.
I'm walking on water.
Whoa!
Just like.
Like who?
Like yeah. A pond skater. Who are you thinking?
No matter. I suppose you thought nothing else in life could surprise you, eh? Wrong.
Yeah, I mean.
Hey, happen to know how the hell I can walk on that water?
Naturally, I know. Since time immemorial have I dwelt in solitude on this shore, and I can testify to the extraordinary nature of the lake.
What's so extraordinary about it? I mean, besides the fact that you can walk on its surface.
A sword, most wondrous, lies in its depths.
Oh, but you can't get underneath.
I watch over it. The blade may be grasped solely by one who possesses the five chivalric virtues.
Folk call me a lot of things, but virtuous? I don't know.
Yet I do know, for I know who you are.
Oh, yeah?
You have proven yourself capable of great sympathy. You are a man of honor, as many can attest.
We try.
Of humble means yourself. You show generosity to others. Your valor is the stuff of legends. Reason guides your actions, as it does those of all who are wise. You have proven the five chivalric virtues dwell in your heart.
Mean the sword's mine? I can dive in and take it?
The sword deserves the hand of a master. You must prove your skills are worthy. Through combat atop the water's surface.
Seriously? Are you ready? Yeah, I'm ready.
anytime.
Then draw your blade.
Who am I fighting? You? Oh god. This is a bad idea. Okay. Whoa, hold on. Jeez.
Come on, come closer.
He's pretty, he's a little bit more than a hermit. Oh, just before he was gonna do something. I think he was gonna, like, teleport or something. Damn it.
This is the last.
Whoa! Blinded.
You have proven worthy of wielding the blade. Beyond all doubt.
In he goes. What the, he just leaves? Walks into the depths and disappears?
Behold, your Arendite.
What?
We've met before.
Yeah.
Certainly. The hermit admitted he knew you, remember?
The Lady of the Lake.
What?
It is I. Forget cool. not that you are a man right and honorable, devoted to doing good. And for these reasons you received the blade. Now bear it. And I trust this time you shall not lose it.
Oh, awesome. Okay, I'm glad we checked this out.
Just wonderful.
And then we sink in. Of course. We are overburdened. That's all fine and good. We can ditch these clothes that we don't need anymore. And all of these little maces. Let's see. Where is... Oh, look at this! It's frickin' beautiful. Each blow generates charges which increase sword damage by 10%. Charges are lost over time or when receiving damage. A fully charged sword always deals critical hit damage. Killing a foe with a fully loaded sword will expend its charge to permanently increase the weapon's damage. What? Damage is increased by 0 right now to a maximum of 10. Okay. Increasing along with your character level. That is cool. That's so awesome. Let's see if we can't get a look at this thing here. Okay. Pretty basic looking there, but let's see what they have to say about the Lady of the Lake. Geralt first encountered the Lady of the Lake when his search for what had been stolen from Kaer Morhen took him to the village known as Murky Waters. There, a mysterious female being dwelled in the murky depths of the village's namesake waters, and... Sorry, there, a mysterious female being dwelled in the murky depths of the village's namesake waters, and watched over the residents living on the shores. That seems weird to me, though. Oh, anyway. Such was their esteem for their underwater guardian, they erected a monument in her honor. Lady of the Lake once had many knights in her service, but they had all died, as valiant knights tend to, during campaigns in far-off lands. She now lived in near solitude, so she was glad to accept Geralt's company, the Witcher being someone she liked and respected. Once the Witcher had believed the Lady of the Lake was some kind of local goddess, but their reunion at Lac Selve made him realize she did not dwell only in murky waters. Instead, Lady of the Lake calls home any place where virtue and chivalry are honored. Cool. That sword, that seems like a really interesting mechanic as well. I'm pretty pumped about that. It looks like... Oh no, that's the stuff that we dropped. I was gonna say, maybe the hermit dropped something, but... I don't think so. Okay. I'm gonna head back to... this area, and then we'll jump over I don't know. Should we just go and meet Damien now? Like, I feel like we could probably do so. All the interesting things have been taken care of. In my opinion, maybe there's stuff that you guys think would be really good to see. If so, this would be the time to let me know. And, I'll take that decision, later. I do also want to do the Gwent things for the rest of the Skellige deck. But I'll do that on, like, a live stream similar to what we did previously. I think that was really fun. A lot of people came out. We had a good time. That was great. Pretty casual. Lots of fun. Good group. But that way, if we keep the Gwent to a single episode, I know some people just aren't into it because they're sickos. But I am into it, so. We'll wait here for now, and if there's any other missions that you guys think are worthy of doing, then let me know. But we'll go from there. See you guys next time. Take care. Bye.